Yo, what up, it's Don.
Sammy Lee here.
Soul Brothers, back up in it. Little dismantled video.
Shout out to fastpass.cn as always. And let's take a look at the Kobe 360. I mean, it's a very minimal shoe. And if you guys want to watch the performance review, of course you guys can. But let's get straight into the, dismantling of the 360. But all right, so getting into this cross-section cut, I mean, there's really nothing too crazy about it besides the midsole, dropping midsole. But, you know, looking at the upper, it's just a 360 Flyknit. You guys can see how thin it is.
I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah, and then, of course, there is some foam padding in the back ankle area, of course, for containment and for comfortability, I guess. But the interesting thing is the drop-in midsole, and you guys can see really how thick the React / Lunalon is. But we'll get into that. But it does look pretty damn thick, to be honest, right?
Yeah.
Alright, but that is the cross-section cut. And this is the upper separated from the outsole. I don't know how they do that, dude. But it's really cool to see. Yes, you're from right here.
Right, it's like a full little sock.
Yeah, exactly. But it's super thin. Really, really thin. I wonder if that does anything, though. Like, do you really need to make it underneath your foot? I don't know. Maybe they could have just cut it where the rubber attaches to the upper and saves some material. But, you know, there's that. And as, from this picture, you guys can see all of the glue work. And that's a lot of glue, of course. Yeah. You need to use some crazy ass glue to, attach the rubber also to the materials. But, alright. So here is the piece that is connected to the bottom of the midsole to grip to the outsole. So here are the support pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not really sure what that 4 foot one does. Maybe it does a little bit or something.
Yeah, it might just give you a little recoil, a little stability in your toe there. But
Also foams do tend to not keep their shape unless there's like a shank or whatever. But that's usually in the midfoot. But I haven't really seen any shoes with a 4 foot shank, so it's pretty interesting. But yeah, it might be for some recoil and to help the foam not misshape. What do you call it? Like to deform.
Warp.
Yeah, warp or deform. Mm-hmm. And so it's just clear plastic, of course.
Yeah.
But anyway, so let's get into the very interesting part of this dismantling, which is the drop-in midsole.
Mm-hmm.
And the yellow part is Lunalon, and then the purple part is React. And
They put a little bit of React underneath in the toe.
No, it's only on the top. It's super thin. Yeah, it's really, really thin, as you guys can see in the 4 foot, but. So I guess what you're feeling is Lunalon mostly, because like the React is super thin, but then you can really feel it in the 4 foot. But the heel is really crazy.
Yeah, that's pure React.
Yeah.
And you can feel that.
It feels amazing. But so here it is. They actually cut it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a little bit harder to see in this picture, but it is a different coloration.
Yeah.
And you guys can see the Lunalon and the React, but the React is really thin in the 4 foot. Which is really interesting, but and then of course in this picture, on the right is a Lunalon, and then on the left is the React.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's pure React. It looks very chunky and very thick in the heel, but of course it really thins out a lot in 4 foot.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's get into actual thickness of the 4 foot. So the 4 foot is 14.59. That's pretty damn thin. The thinnest I think is like 12 to 13 millimeters, so 14.59 is actually pretty damn thin. And then in the heel is 18.40 millimeters thick, and that is a 4 millimeter offset, which is actually really flat. There's really no offset there. And of course, here is just the 360 upper.
Thin outsole also.
Yeah, very
just
thin
the
outsole.
Outsole is crazy thin.
Yeah, and you can definitely you can see through that.
Yeah.
Thin. And then most of the durability and force is being put on the midsole, as you guys already know, because the midsole comes up a lot. It's 4.27 millimeters thick for the outsole.
Wow.
So 4.27 plus, whatever, that was, the 14.59 is around 18-19 millimeters thick in the 4 foot, and like 22-23 millimeters. So that's actually, you're pretty high off the ground.
Yeah.
Compared to like, you know, other shoes that are, you know, a lot thinner. But you know, that's about it. I was very surprised at how thin the React was in the forefoot, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I was also surprised at how, you know, not close to the ground you were, but like you feel pretty damn low for some reason.
Yeah, you do.
Maybe it's just because how minimal the shoe feels on foot. But anyways, that is the dismantling of the Kobe 360. Very, very simple shoe, but they're charging $200. I mean, what do you think the materials are?
What do you mean?
Like, how much money does it cost Nike to make this shoe?
God, I don't even
like
know.
Like, $10-$20?
Probably something like
Jesus.
That.
And then, like, just seeing how simple and, like, and how minimal this shoe is, they're still charging $200, but...
They're charging you all for R&D.
Yeah, I mean, research and development, obviously. But anyways, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you on the next one.
Later. Peace.